After is my first album, and it's for me it represents the third and final album in what has become kind of a trilogy, beyond the fact that all these albums start with letter A. Whereas The Adversary and Angel were more confrontational and more in conflict and very direct in its expression, I wanted this album, as the title kind of implies, with after, I wanted back to kind of after the conflict and dwell more on the desolate landscapes that remain, back to more epic and more contemplation rather than just direct confrontation. And there's no sign of life in any of the lyrics, and that became kind of a rule of thumb for the whole album. And yeah, I'm very, very pleased with the result. I think it captures some of that emotion and that intensity. As for collaborators, I've stayed with Asgeir Mikkelsson on drums. He recorded the drums with Børge Finstad at the Top Rope Studios, and also Lars Norberg have been doing the bass, and both of them again been doing a fantastic job over these albums that I've collaborated with them. I feel I've kind of develop the trust needed to kind of give them more room, and they've I feel, you know, taking that space and really interpreted things in a way that really complements the material I provide. So I'm very happy with that. And on The Adversary and Angel, I have had guest vocalists. Garm from Ulve on the first album, and Mikael from Opeth on the second one. But this time, given the kind of epic and non-lively atmosphere of this new album, I got to fulfill some kind of a dream of having a saxophone player on the album. And after doing some research, I ended up in a collaboration with Jørgen Munkeby of Shining, and what can I say? He came in and did a fantastic interpretation in a mixture of playing lines that I'd prepared and some fantastic improvisations, like right there and then. And it really added a very cool element to the album, I think, that goes through it, and he plays on four of the songs on the album, and that was kind of the silver lining that this album needed, I think. I'm very happy with that. Now that I've finished my third solo album, I guess I feel more confident and feel the way that I've built myself a bit of a new musical foundation, also beyond what I did earlier in extreme metal, which in some form is important for me to try and build something new, but also ending this first trilogy that I initially wanted to make. I kind of both create a new musical platform, whereas ending it, you know, in part also gives me the liberation of not being stuck to that foundation when I want to move on musically. And also, I've taken this project from just being in the studio, and after the second album I did two live shows, to also as an experiment to see how this material would work in that setting. And the material, I think, worked well, and I was also lucky to have a band called Leprous being my backing band, that did a very, very professional and good job and made it easy for me to perform it live. And this is also something I want to develop after this album and do more live shows and kind of explore this new music in that form as well.